Hi, this is Megan Weber. I'm an extension educator here at the University of Minnesota focusing on aquatic invasive species. And today I'm going to give you some tips to identify invasive yellow iris even when there aren't any flowers present. So you may know that in Minnesota, we do have two native varieties of iris. There's both a northern and a southern blue flag iris. And then we have an invasive yellow iris. When the flowers are present, it's really easy to tell the difference between the natives and the invasive because the natives have a blue or purple flower and the invasive one has a yellow flower. But when those flowers are gone, there's still a trick to see the difference. So I'm going to show that to you now. So here's the two flowers. And like I said, real easy to tell the difference between the two. Big yellow flower for the invasive and a beautiful blue or purple flower for the native. And then once we get out into the field, you can see quickly that this is the native iris because it has lots of beautiful blue purple flowers showing. And we'll take a quick closer look at that flower. Here you can see it. This one happens to be the southern variety. That yellow patch is probably the easiest way to tell. It's that big, bold yellow in the southern variety and a little bit more faded, maybe olivey yellow in the northern. But iris flowers have a pretty standard shape. They have three petals. These are the petals that you can see now. So three of those. And then the sepals are the big showy parts. And there's three sepals. So a real standard iris flower shape. That's true for both the yellow and the blue flag iris. So now if we look at this patch of iris instead, there aren't any flowers here to give us a really good hint at which variety this might be. You can see as we get closer here, these are actually the seed pods. So these still have some development to do, but when they're done, they'll be kind of puffy and full of iris seeds. But if you look at the leaves now, you can see the center part of the leaf. And as I run my thumb over it, I can feel that where it's real thick, it's almost ridged, going all the way down to the base and back up. It's on both sides of the leaf. So as I turn the leaf over here, you'll be able to see that really sharp thickening on both sides. So this is real common in the yellow iris. And now as we move back over to that native blue flag iris, we'll take a look at the leaves here. You can see they all have this flattened kind of fan shape from the base. That's present in all iris. But as we look at the leaf and where it thickens in the center, it's not nearly so ridged. There's definitely a thickening, but it's much more gradual. You don't get that kind of harsh edge like you might on many of the yellow iris. And with that, I'll leave you with one final note about yellow iris, which is to use caution around it, especially if there's any broken leaves or stems, because the saps and resins can cause blistering and irritation to the skin. I hope you enjoyed today's video and learned something new about identifying yellow iris.